So I'm Victor, I'm 37 years old, and I have a lump. This lump started the last few years when I got off work one day. I feel this tingling on my chest, and it's just like a pimple. And I mash it, like a massive amount of stuff comes out. Over the next couple of days, it just healed like any scab would. And over the years, it just got bigger and bigger and bigger. I have 3 children, so it's like a knob. You know, they want to use it to pull up on, and they play with it like it's a joystick. My daughter likes to lay on me watching TV shows and so forth. They basically use me as a jungle gym. And then this thing is there. I've named this lump. The lump's named Larry, Larry the Lump Lump. And Larry needs to get out of the way.
Knock, knock. I hear there's a Victor in here. Hi.
Hi.
Are you Victor?
I am Victor.
Nice to meet you. I'm
Good
Sandra.
To meet you.
Dr. Lee, please have a seat.
So I have a little problem. Larry, you might be able to help
me. Who is Larry? And what is Larry?
Larry's here.
Okay. Close to your chest?
Yes. Yeah.
Close to
my
heart. Yes. All right, so I think I'm mentally prepared.
Okay.
I'm gonna take a look at Larry for you.
Dun.
Uh-oh. Right. We need some Larry music.
Yeah, I know, right? Maybe we'll get some.
Oh, yeah, you do have a little Larry there.
Yeah.
May I touch Larry's head?
Yes.
Larry's yes? Okay. In general, this is called a tumor. It doesn't mean that it's life-threatening. It doesn't mean that it's dangerous. It just means a growth on the skin. You know, I know you're probably really concerned where it is because it's right in the middle of our chest. We know we have a lot of important organs under here, but we have ribs under there.
Yeah.
And that is protecting our heart and our lungs from me getting anywhere near it.
Yeah.
When I'm removing something of this size, I'm not taking my sharp scissors and probing straight down deep. I'm slowly using curved, blunt scissors and trying to get underneath this sort of growth without traumatizing anything deeper. I only want to go as deep as I need to. Okay, people, we got Victor here. He's got like a pretty big cyst. I think it's a cyst. And it looks like it's literally hatching from his body. I think it's a cyst. If it's spiders, I'm out.
I'm not doing it.
I'm out of the room. You guys are gonna have to finish it up. So let's get started with that. I think that we're just gonna use a regular surgical kit with, you know, 3 and 4. Make sure you wear your splash masks and we should be set. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Got it.
Okay, just a little baby pinch here. Okay, baby pinch. You okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, this is your splash screen. Here, let me show you how to use this. I'm giving Victor a splash mask because you never know how a cyst will act. I've had cysts squirt and hit me really close to my eye. If I had my mouth open, maybe hit me in the mouth. That's why I wear splash masks now. That's why I should have invested back in splash masks way back in the day because I'm going through them like candy. Okay, you shouldn't feel anything other than us touching you, all right?
Okay.
Okay. Hi guys, Dr. Sandra Lee here. You also know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. Let me present to you Skittle steatocystoma. This gentleman has steatocystomas and they're all over his body, but the ones that really bother him are the ones on his forehead. Steatocystomas are like a sac that contains oil glands in it. So what is secreted out into them is like an oily material, which is why I kind of call it like butter because it does look like melted butter. We don't know why, but some people just get them and sometimes they can get a lot of them. And when you get a lot of them, it's called steatocystoma multiplex. Any place is nerve-wracking to make an incision, but you know, in particular, I think the face is an area that I'm very concerned about the incision and what it looks like because it is the face and it is the way that we present ourselves to other people. When you're making an incision on the face, obviously I'm trying to minimize the scar as much as possible. I'm trying to minimize the incision line, the length of it. I'm also paying attention to what we call resting skin tension lines, which means the lines that were naturally the curves of our face. There's lines that we certainly make when we make certain facial expressions. So in this particular area on the forehead, I'm paying attention to how our expressions kind of create creases on our forehead and trying to hide any kind of incision along that direction. It's hard to know when you're gonna get everything out. I mean, I think that's part of doing this all the time, you start to learn about it. I mean, honestly, 3 years ago, I don't think I had removed any steatocystomas. I mean, we've seen them, I've diagnosed them, but I've never really removed them because they're cosmetic. They're not really medically necessary to remove. Steatocystomas in particular, what I've learned is that they have a very flimsy kind of sac wall. A flimsy sac wall, but yet it doesn't tear really easily, so you can usually kind of wiggle and pull it out. And so if you know you've gotten that sort of flimsy, really thin kind of membrane out, you're pretty sure that you've got it all. This patient came to me once a month or so. I think I've seen him, I'm gonna guess around 7-8 times. It's interesting because he is not a papaholic. His wife is, and she's a lovely woman. She comes with him to the appointments. She would never miss them because she wants to be a part of it.
That's a good one.
Yeah. He's motivated because it has changed his appearance, but his wife is really getting a lot of joy out of watching them being done. So I think she's happy that he's having them done and he's feeling better about his appearance, but she's also really enjoying the process.
Gosh, you just store stuff in there. It's quite amazing, really.
So I hope you enjoyed this glimpse at Skittle steatocystoma. Thank you for watching.
I'm right on top of Larry. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Good. It is a cyst, absolutely a cyst. Larry's like a little lava right here. I'm gonna squeeze him out a little bit, okay?
Ooh.
Yeah. Larry's like mud. Okay, ready? I'm gonna squeeze again. So make sure I'm not hurting you too bad, okay? Everybody's got it?
When I squeezed it initially, it came out in two different directions, and that's because there were two little cuts in the cyst wall.
This reminds me of that Beauty and the Beast. Do you know the line I'm thinking of?
No.
Try the gray stuff, it's delicious.
Oh my God.
You okay?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna push a little bit more because it's a little bit more. It's like two fangs. Mine's got two fangs. You know, I think that cyst colors are different because of our pigment in our skin. You and I have a little more pigment, so we can tend to get ones that are more darker color. I think a person who's really light complected probably won't as likely get a real dark one. And I'm gonna try to get that sac wall out of there at this point.
I'm working really hard to get the sac out because it's really kind of adherent. It's stuck there to his chest. Victor is really easygoing. He doesn't seem to be too bothered by this, so that makes things a lot easier.
We got it out. All right, let's put a stitch in there. Fix you up. That was a good pop.
That was a good pop.
Okay, so this, it's just brown, which will lighten over time.
Yeah.
It'll take time, keep it out of the sun.
That is awesome.
Larry, the loser, has left the facility. Hopefully he's gone on to the afterlife. RIP, Larry.
Okay, you ready for Larry? Because he was a messy one.
Oh my God.
Yeah, all this squeezed out of him. It's just wet, mashed up skin cells.
Oh my God, it's got chunks in it. That is so nasty.
Larry was like the devil's creamsicle.
I'll give you a moment to say goodbye, okay? I'll give you a moment alone.
Is there gonna be like sappy music now?
Yeah, you can cry, you can shed a tear for Larry. Yeah. Okay?
Thank you.
You're so welcome. You're awesome.
You too.
Now I can go back home and let my daughter Maya lay on my chest in peace.
See you, Larry.
Larry's gone.
Larry's gone.
So I'm good. Yeah, we doing good today. Yeah.